I think actually what's more interesting to me is even from 2010 and 11 to today, I think we've seen an incredible shift in entrepreneurship. And the shift to me, if I look back at sort of 4 or 5 years ago, technology was this thing that was hot, it was hyped, it was coming, it was sort of still outside of the normal career paths. And if you were working on a startup and you told your normal friends, they would sort of roll their eyes and think you were just trying to emulate Facebook.
You're talking very specifically about New York, I feel like, because in the Valley...
I'm not talking only about New York. I think in the Valley you've seen even a similar explosion, just in terms of the variety of the types of startups. And that's where I'm going
with this is
I think in 2010, 11, tech was still going to disrupt normal industries, and tech was coming to media, coming to fashion, coming to all these other industries. And I think fast forward literally 3-4 years, and what you see now is that technology is the only thing that every single company understands that their future is based on. And so if you are a traditional company in an industry, so whether it's a real estate leasing company or it's a company that manages oil rigs in the Gulf, or you're a fashion house in New York, or you're a media company, technology is the only thing that you're focused on in terms of how we're going to innovate our business. And I think that pendulum swung in such a short amount of time, where it went from a nice to have and okay, it's sort of our R&D labs thing, to this is the core focus, right? The New York Times today is a technology company. That's crazy. The New York Times is no longer focused on printing newspapers. They're focused on drawing users to their online or mobile properties. And I think you've seen that shift happen in such a short amount of time. And as an investor, you see that shift happening in so many different industries. So Warby Parker or Harry's, which is in no way thought of as a technology company, because of the internet, because of new distribution channels, have been able to disrupt an eyeglasses industry or an old stodgy razor industry. And I think that those are the things that in the past 3 years, the development in entrepreneurship and in technology have really unlocked.